All right, guys, we're working on Ray's yard man again. The recoil came out of it. We're going to just sit here and talk and see if we can figure it out at the shop. Hopefully we wind it the right way and the spring's not shot in or something. I wonder if it's going to have tension.
It's got to have tension, definitely.
Before you put the rope in.
Well, that's what I got to figure out here.
Yeah.
And I got to figure out how we're going to get the tension.
Well, you got to put your screwdriver in once you get the tension in it. I think the rope is fixing something with the tension.
The rope has nothing to do with it. This ain't my first rodeo, but he's been a long time.
Yeah, it's freaking lawnmower jumps, guys, I tell ya. We got other push mowers we might be looking around here with today, maybe just this one.
Just got a new drop of shit on it.
It's raining, hope my camera don't get ruined, guys. It's not even, it was waterproof, but the button fell off of it, and it's
just a shower.
Yeah, it's a sprinkle, it'll be okay. We're just filming the rain.
Alright, so this is going this way.
Yeah, it's either gonna go clockwise or counterclockwise.
And then when you pull this, these things come out. Mm. They don't. It keeps it there. See, there's no tension. Mm. See? When you hold it, then these pop out.
Yeah.
That's what turns the flywheel.
That's why I thought you were supposed to turn it without the cord, and it should make a difference. I wonder if it goes this way. Maybe if I hold the rope and just keep turning it. Go like this. So, it gets pulled like this, so it's going to get wound this way. So I wonder if we hold the springs and unwind it. I don't know if that makes a difference. Well, it flows.
Right.
Just be careful. Take that off there, I guess, guys. Let's see if we can wind it. It did work before the rope snapped. Is it twisted? Okay. We're just getting the summer showers. We're doing this, guys.
Yeah, but what I'm afraid of, see, there's springs here.
All the lot.
There's springs there.
Weird. You feel the springs?
Oh, geez.
Is there tension? There is no.
That's why I'm not taking it off, because that'll come off, springs will pop out, and then the main spring underneath all that'll pop out of there.
Are you going to hold it open and turn it? Maybe that's what the problem is, you're going to hold it open and you start to turn it. I think I figured it out, it's getting tension. Oh well, we're getting our ass whacked. Hopefully the camera holds like this. Oops, it's not working. I can deal with that. Alright, take your finger around. Now tighten it up, right? Before it fucks up.
Tension.
It's going to be close enough to tension. this weird. I don't see anything like that.
See, that's the problem. I mean, you put it down there and it just pulls, but it ain't gonna go back in.
Let's try it the other way. He's gotta keep screwing it in there or something.
Another spring.
I'm not sitting out here in this rain.
It'll stop, won't it?
It might.
There's gotta be something in this. You see that little spring there? Something's gotta clip or something.
Yeah, but see, that's what I'm saying. These lock out to hit the flywheel.
Yeah, something to do with the flywheel springs. What was that? That's all I can think of. It has something to do with the flywheel light springs. Because, look. That's all I can think of. We're gonna stop it here. We might have hopefully that was at the diner, guys. We'll stop here. We'll come back. Alright guys, believe it or not, these are same. They have same carburetor. They're this one's probably like a China Kohler, and this is actually the Kohler. They are both the same, so we're taking the recoil off this one and I'm putting it on this one. So hopefully I can get this camera set up on a tripod and we can see what you're doing, what we're doing, or what you're doing. They're watching us, guys. Alright guys, we're gonna switch covers. Hopefully this one will reach over here. When we get the other recoil fixed, we'll put it on the other one.
That bad boy.
Alright, well, back in the weeds it goes. Back in the Loch Ness weed monsters. Alright guys, Ray's gonna try and start while I push the other one back in the weeds. Gas, can smell it. I can smell it. It smells funky though.
Had a full tank of gas up in there, I thought, when I first started.
Gas smells funky. With water or something. There's no gas in there.
Ain't no water in that gas. Yeah.
You got a can?
I ain't gonna do none of that shit.
Dump some gas in the mouth of it, maybe.
Tilt this up, this side up.
Yeah.
Tilt it up in the air. Easy.
Okay.
Easy.
That's it. The chump's closing, don't we? Alright, move that. Yeah, it closes.
Is it closed now?
No, it's open.
No.
Closed.
It's closed now?
Yeah, yeah. This thing is to start on the first pull.
That's what it was designed to do on the first pull.
Yeah. Try dumping some gas in the carb or something. I don't want to spill it all over either.
Well, that's the whole thing. You got it. Yeah. Bring that over here.
Might be good for the rings to start it. You dump it though.
Hold this up. Hold this up.
There. I want to take the back off and just put a little in.
Hold this up.
Yeah.
Choke is open right now.
No, it's closed.
No, choke is open.
Oh, I see. Open means it's closed. Okay.
All the way in is open. All the way out is closed.
Okay.
Tilt it, keep it up all the way as far as you can.
Be careful. Close the choke. See what this does. Oops. There she goes. We're just gonna sit with it, guys. Thank you. Seems to like to run on choke. Is that where it should be? That's where it should be, right? It smells weird. Stick some rocks and sticks in it, see how it does on the 63. Well.
Sounds good.
Cotton? Hopefully it cuts. You might want to choke it a little more if you want to cut. Yeah, we used to run that thing on choke all the time, guys. Cool, we finally got her going, guys. Not sure when you're seeing this video. It's Saturday. You know what the date is? Yeah, guys, it's gotta be the 24th we're making this. I let it run and burn on all the gas. Only seems to want to run on choke. You only need to do one of those, the other one's the self-propelled. Alright. For some reason it likes to run on show.
Carburetor's never probably been cleaned either.
We cleaned it. Don't you remember we did that last year?
I thought I put a new filter in it.
Yeah, we did, but the filter's like gone, guys. I wonder what the heck happened to it.
It's still a Saturday night hookers. I got Saturday night pickers.
Saturday night mowers.
Pick up what they want.
Hookers are great. They can pick up mowers with you. You don't have to sleep with them, guys. You can even pay a hooker to put a roof on your house and clean out the gutters.
I got them bolts and that piece of pipe off and that flagpole the other day.
Okay. I heard you. I saw you doing that one day.
Oh,
we gotta fix that flagpole. Freaking neighbor kids or something broke the flagpole, guys. Or
know something about it.
Yeah. Someone probably just went like this and held it, took their freaking foot and just knocked it down.
Wind blows from the...
Yeah, the wind didn't take that down.
The east.
And then there's a Kohler engine he had over there. That's missing. That was there a while.
We never had winds that big enough to bend over that.
No, it could have bent a while. It was a person.
Because it's not rusty.
It was a windy frickin' person.
Sure. See, I leveled up that grill.
Oh, you did? What'd you use?
The wheel underneath it.
Okay. Yeah, Ray picked up a grill recently. I'll show it to you in a minute, guys. Just gonna be careful what I show. I don't want to show too much, but see the grill, guys? Yeah, we're gonna work on Ray's yard soon and get it wiped out and clean.
Wiped out.
What happened is his nephew had a car in the garage and took all the stuff out of the garage. His nephew was supposed to help him put it back in there, and it never happened. And then, right around the time it happened, I was
on vacation
somewhere, incapacitated, and I couldn't help but put it back in. I wanted to take my weed whacker to that, but it's just easier to rake the shit out of there.
Well, that's the problem. Just like when I weed whacked out back out there,
yeah.
All that tall grass, you still gotta pick it up.
Yeah, or you can go over it several times.
Yeah, that's a bunch of shit.
That's a waste, really.
Yeah.
Or I want a bagger. Yeah. I should have got that stamper with the bagger. That would have been nice.
Well, that's the thing. If you get the right one, they got one down there that they use down there. And
something.
It's nice.
Yeah.
I used to have the stamper.
They had those Comets like years ago where the bagger was like in a dump cart or something.
I bought a Troy built bagger to go on the back of my Ryder.
Yeah, we never did that. Where is it? It's somewhere.
Sits over there somewhere.
Yeah, I gotta fix that Troy belt next.
For the rest of it.
Fix the flat in those tires, it should work.
I'll fix
it. Fix the flat. It work better on back tires than front tires.
Oh, Clarence did take that one tire and put it in the van. You know that rear end from that other Troy belt?
Yeah.
That I gave him to get up the thing off?
You got the tires off?
He got one off. He's going to take the other one down the shop and pull it apart.
Oh, good.
I said, after all this time, Clarence?
Yeah. We had the other transmission we had from the Troy belt when we did it.
You're
going to
move, so now you're doing all this stuff.
Yeah.
Before, when you
don't mention too much on camera.
You know, that...
Yeah, race relations a little bit weird.
A little bit.
Everybody's relations weird. You got weird people in everybody's family.
We're all related somehow.
Yep.
No matter what color skin, we're all related.
Oh, we're all the same. We got all the same blood.
Yep.
Remember, I don't even know if I should mention this. Archie Bunker, there was an episode where he needed a blood transfusion years ago in the 70s, and they put black blood in him, like African-American woman or something blood in him, and that really got him to stop making so many awful comments. And then someone was mouthing off to one of his black friends, and he says, I got black blood in me, and you're calling me the same thing or something. That was a good show, all the family. They don't have too many good shows anymore.
Not anymore, they don't. They got garbage.
Yeah. Well, some of the shows are good.
Garbage.
Yes. So the stuff I watch is garbage, kind of that Japanese
anime. They need to have a thing on your remote that the people that pays for cable, they can watch, and if it's garbage, you can delete it, put it in the garbage can.
I know some, like a computer. We're recording here. I'll do the hamburger soon, Mom. Well, they have voice app automated TV style. You can, like, yell and go to a channel and something. What are they doing?
I don't
know. It's not moving.
Going back down. All these people get these brilliant ideas for their house.
Yeah.
But I know one thing, and it's not two things, and not 10 things. Any of these mowers that are intentionally going to be left to fix or whatever, and that zero turn and all this other stuff is not being left out all winter.
No, what
my rototiller's not being left out. That's going inside.
Yeah.
I'm gonna fire that up again.
Yeah. That rototiller, we need the points on.
It's just something that...
There's a funny story on that rototiller, guys. I looked it up on the internet. There was a recalled product. People were getting hurt using it. Because back then, they didn't really have any safety things on there. People are getting, like, their feet near the rototiller and doing all sorts of stupid shit. I read, like, a comment guy got his foot chewed off by one of them, so...
Well, if you're foolish enough to put the feet in front of the rototiller.
Why would you want your feet here? You're trying to play footsies with it or something? That's almost as bad as sticking your hand under a lawnmower. So.
Yeah. But, see, that back in the day, they didn't have all the safety stuff on a lot of this.
Well, people had sense.
People had sense. Not a lot of dollars, but they had sense.
And you can even install a simple toggle switch on the lawnmower, like to shut it off if it tips over or something.
Right.
I never once tipped over my snapper. I did climb it up the side of the house one time years ago when I didn't know anything. I didn't really use it. And I got so close to Ray's house on the other side there, I didn't even hit it. I never hit the car with the stamper.
We backed real close to the house this time.
Yeah. Yeah. That ditch is hard because you got to go over there, and Ray got stuck in the mud getting some stuff out of here. They have to go over to the boats.
I got to dig that ditch out too.
Yeah.
I got to dig them pipe things out of there.
Summer is never-ending work story, guys. Work all the time. I'm always outside here in the summer. Now I got to wear this freaking hat because I had a freaking bald spot. It looks like a... Or you get one of those little, should not say this, forgive me guys, I'm not like that, but like a little, what do they call them, yarmulke? Like a Jewish cap or something to put on there. That's how the Jewish people, they cover up their bald spots, put like a yarmulke there. They're like, oh, you know, bald, yeah. And it is like this vintage snapper hat, guys, it's awesome.
I know with that Ranger up there, I thought about putting that up out of the lake, and I thought about putting the van here, right?
Yeah, you could put, maybe put the van over there.
But then I said, no, van's going.
Yeah, I get the van going.
But with that truck over there, I could take some of the stuff that's going to be junk and put right on the truck.
Yeah, we'll
get a load onto it, get it out of here.
Yeah, we should keep the push mowers at least, get them moving.
That Troy built.
Put a couple of them on Facebook or something, get them going and just have extras on there.
That Troy built, that extra frame thing there,
that
needs to be stripped out what's good onto it and also be shot away.
Well, that hood is going to go onto this one because that hood's broke.
Right. Wow. I'm talking about the rusted frame that sits over there. In the high weeds.
That could be used for motor tester someday, but just get it gone. And what you want to do is that's cooler wiring right there you got in that one, but you want to keep the Briggs wiring because that would wire up to another Briggs wiring harness. That was a Briggs... that was a Briggs freaking Troy belt, and the transmissions are the same. So that's Briggs wiring harness.
Yeah,
you do want to keep that.
Yeah, put it in this one.
Yeah, when Steve did that.
Yeah.
It doesn't take much to do these mowers. Anybody can do it, guys. It's like 12-year-old kids doing it and stuff.
Patience.
You have patience. And lately, I've just been losing my freaking stuff. I had like yelling at the Snapper Comet because it was leaking oil. I'm looking at it like, why?
I got in on that porch is my big can with my drill bits.
Yeah.
I gotta find it because I got a drill bit. I gotta drill a big hole in it and to put that few bolts in it.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna spray the hell out of them because they're rusty.
Yeah. Ray was talking about God ham or something, like the ham that the Jewish people eat. That's really terrible, I'm sorry. Kosher ham or something. Yeah, we're trying to watch it with the language and some stuff can't be. Honestly, when I was up there, I don't know if I even put this up or you haven't seen it yet, guys. When I was cutting the trees on the hill, I was pushing them forward, and I fell forward onto the thing and almost stabbed me in the freaking stomach, and I yelled, "Got ham," or "Got ham," or something, and I'm going to probably censor it. I might censor Ray saying, "Got ham." I don't know. I think he said, "Got ham." You got to just take this cursing what it is. For what it is.
I weed eated this year.
Yeah, the garden.
Yeah, and I didn't do that over there because there's a lot of dent around.
Purple flowers?
Daisies.
Those daisies.
I'm going to leave them. Yeah. You'll like them daisies.
Daisies are great. Your roses came out too, finally.
Yeah, they finally come out. Yep.
Yeah.
I got to get some Miracle-Gro again. Throw on to them.
Yeah, I bet Miley Cyrus and Snoop Dogg love Miracle-Gro. They should be Snoop Dogg should be an endorser of Miracle-Gro.
Oh, while you're sitting there, Mike, catch up.
Well, no, what is it?
Not hard.
Uh-oh. What are we going to do?
What we got to do, we
got to pick up this. What is the workbench, guys. Or the bench. See what we got. Oh, it just focused. Look at that. Watch. Oh. What are we going to do? Move the Troy belt back?
No, fine.
like robbing too. Leave it. Another day. Put it on our effort list, our bucket list.
I might want to keep it one of these days.
Maybe Sunday we can mess with one of them.
I'm going in there.
All right. All right, Ray's going in the house and I'm making dinner. Take care, guys. Good night.
Good night.
Bye, guys.
Thank you all and all that.
Yep, and watch out for our hams.